Hola, ¿qué tal?
Hello everyone,
Hola a todos.
welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store.
En el video de hoy
Today
veremos un repaso
we are going to
del
review
ATM,
the ATM,
el sistema que usa Ninja
a
Trader
system
para
used by
administrar
NinjaTrader
todos los
to
trades.
manage trades.
Y
And
de paso vamos a ver un
we
método
are
de conexión que nos
also
permite
going to
probar
review
HTTP
a
ese
connection
código
method that
simulado.
it is very useful to
Volviendo
test
a
or
conectarnos.
our ATMs. So we connect to the to this data feed, simulated data feed.
En esta cuenta tenemos
And here we have a slider
que podemos
that
mover
we
para
can
arriba
use
abajo
to
y
move the market to the upside
para
or
arriba.
to the downside.
La
So
idea
you
es
can
que
test
cuando estamos
or trailing
gestionando
stops and
un ATM
outbreak
que
events
tenga N objetivos con un trailing
moving the
stop,
market
con esto podemos
to
realmente
the
probar
direction
lo que
that
estamos haciendo.
we want.
Entonces,
So
vamos al chart trader.
let's go to chart
Acá
trader. We click here.
lo ponemos en modo
We
visible.
set it to visible
Y
mode.
esto que tenemos acá es el
And then
ATM.
what we
Con
have
todas
here
nuestras
is the
definiciones
ATM
que
with
hemos
all
grabado.
our
Vamos a ver ahora,
definitions.
por ejemplo,
Let's view now, for example.
vamos a agregarle líneas horizontales acá
Let's
cada 10
add
ticks también para
horizontal
poder ir
lines each 10 ticks so we have an idea of the size of the targets and
líneas
stops.
horizontales
So
en
we
ticks
place
cada 10 ticks. Como
horizontal
vemos, la
lines each
propiedad
10
del
ticks
chart
and
decimos que van a estar en las
on the
líneas
properties of the chart
horizontales,
we enable
grid line horizontal
the grid line in
descending.
horizontal mode. Something like
Dentro de
this.
esta ya sabemos que
So
hay
now we
10
have an
ticks.
idea of how many ticks we
Nosotros
have
también
available
queremos
on a
tener un
trade.
objetivo de
So
10
let's
ticks
say that I
y
want to
otro de
have
20
a
ticks,
target of
con un
10
stop
ticks
de 10 ticks.
and another of 20
Entonces,
with a
aquí
stop
elegimos
of
custom
10. So we choose custom.
y acá decimos cuál es el trade size que
And
tiene esa
here we
posición. Va a
select
tener
the
dos
trade
contratos
size.
porque uno va a ser
On
muy
this case,
pequeño
we
y
are
el
going
otro
to
va a ser muy
have
grande.
two contracts, one
Entonces, acá
for
le
the
vamos a
target
agregar
one and the other for
tenemos
the
dos
target two.
objetivos. El
So we
trade
have
size del primero es de 1, el trade
the
size del segundo
quantity
también es de
size
1
for
y el stop
each
dijimos que le vamos a
position.
poner 10
The
ticks
stop is 10
a las dos
ticks
posiciones
for both positions.
y el profit de la primera
The profit
10
of the first
y el
is
de la
10
segunda
and the
20.
second is 20.
Después vamos a ver cómo se
Then
usa
we
el
can check
stop.
how is the
A esto
stop
le ponemos
strategy.
un nombre.
We
Acá hay varias
save
opciones para
this with a
usar. En
template.
general
We have more options
vamos
here,
siempre a
but
los más usuales, pero le podemos decir que, por
these are
ejemplo,
not the most
si
useful.
llegamos
But
a
for example,
encontrar
we can
el trade se
reverse
despierta
the
o en total
position
el stop
when
se da
touching
vuelta
the stop
o incluso en el
or
target
even when touching the
que
target.
siga al
We can
objetivo.
make
Si esto se
also
está aproximando
to
al target,
chase
el
the
trade se va un
target
poquito más arriba.
Or
El
also
chase es
the
un mínimo
entry.
para la entrada.
This is the
Cuando se
chase
va
for the entry,
acercando,
when you have a
ese es
limit entry.
la orden limit va siguiendo a la entrada.
But
Pero lo
these are
vamos a
not the
probar con
most
esto.
used functions
Esto
of
lo
the
tenemos que grabar
ATM.
con un nombre
We need to
para
save
poder
this with
elegirlo
a
en los
name, so
tickets.
we have it
Vamos a
listed
ponerle
on the
un nombre, por
ATM
ejemplo.
list. We can
Ejemplo.
select a name.
Save. Ah, ya existe. Bueno, vamos a grabarlo con ese nombre. Ejemplo. Ahí está
And
seleccionado.
now we have the ATM
Y acá
selected.
supongamos que si
So
entramos a
if I
mercado,
click on Buy Market,
del lado acá compramos, del lado acá
or
vendemos. Si compramos a mercado, nos va a entrar el
we get
límite
an
de precio en
entry
ese momento
where the price
comparado
is
a 10
at that
ticks
moment
y a
with the
20
target
ticks el
placed
target
at
y
10
a
and
otros
20
10
ticks
ticks
and
el
also the
stop.
stops for both positions at 10
Ahora,
ticks from the entry.
el ATM acá
The ATM
sí
here
cambió bastante
has
rápido.
a little ray on the left
Si
side
vemos el
of the
desplegable de
banner.
Minca, acá
If
tenemos
we look
todos los
at the
ATMs que tenemos
list,
grabados
we can see that
arriba
at
de
the
los que están
top
activos.
we have the
Esto quiere
currently
decir que el ATM
active
que está
ATM. So
seleccionado
that means
es
that
el
this ATM
ATM actual, no
corresponds
es
to
un
the
nuevo ATM.
current
Quiere
trade
decir
size.
que yo acá, si
So
llego a poner
if we
un
execute a
contrato
trade with the
y le doy comprar,
currently ATM,
lo que hace es
then
aumentar un
we add
contrato
a
a esta
contract
posición.
or
Lo compra
we
a mercado donde
subtract a
sea que esté,
contract.
por ejemplo, acá abajo.
For
Y
example,
acá
here, if we
veo.
click on buy,
Y
it
aumenta el
adds
stop.
a contract to the position, also to the targets, and also to the stops. If, for example, I place a buy stop, when the market touch that place, it increases the trade size of the current ATM. The same we can do with the stop. If we make the market goes up, instead of moving up the stop, we can place an exit. We can remove one position with a sell stop, only one contract. So we place a sell stop, and now if the market goes down, we currently have one target and one stop. So if we place this sell stop near the market, this sell stop is going to remove the position and also the targets and the stops, because all is related to the same ATM. So let's repeat. If I have selected an ATM, let's say I want to enter short when it reaches this level. It will enter the market using this ATM. We already have the ATM selected with the array. If, for example, I want to add another contract on this place, then instead of starting a new ATM, it adds a contract to the currently to the current ATM. So the target and stops are not moved, they are just updated with the new trade size. On the chart trader we can change that way of work. If we right click and go to properties, we can see that here we can select, if I want to select the same ATM, or select a new one, for example. If I select a new one, when I click on sell, I have now two positions, two different trades with different ATMs. They are not related between them. This method of working, that when it auto-selects the last ATM used, we can change it from the properties. Here, instead of this method, we keep selected the ATM. So if I want to enter several times, but all times with different ATM, then we can do this method. So I select an ATM, this one for example. Now I enter long. So I have my target, my stop, and now we can see that I don't have the array on the ATM because the ATM remains locked. So if I click again on long, now I have a second ATM, but all of them are different and they are listed at the top with different rays. Then we have a third method. This one displays selected ATM strategies only. Let's leave the market flat. Let's say that we have two charts.
Y a duplicar este chart.
And I want to be long on one chart and short on the other. For example, using this ATM on the left chart and the same ATM on the second chart. Now here I want to go long. And on the right I want to go short. I have selected the new ATM, not the current one, so that's okay. Because on properties I have keep selected ATM, so that's okay. When I started the new ATM, the current ATM keep selected. Now, I don't see a position, because the global position is flat. One is long, the other is short. But I can see the target and stops of both positions. But if I want to view the trade, the corresponding trade for each one, then for that is this option. If I want to show only the selected ATM, I get a warning, because we must be careful with this option, because it is not showing everything. It is only showing the orders of the ATM that we select on the slider. So if I select here one of the active ATMs, the first or the second, now it shows the position and the orders corresponding to that. So if I select one, it is long. If I select the other, it is short. I can do the same on the other chart. I get again the same warning. The warning is because it is dangerous. We can think that we are flat or we are long, but we are not looking at all the picture. We are only looking at one ATM. So now here I am looking at the short, and on the other chart I am looking at the long. Now let's say that one of the trade is finished. So the short gets a profit and goes flat. Target filled. Now, I still see a position, but this position is not from this ATM. If I want to select a new ATM, if I select the current ATM, I see all the position and orders. The position is always visible. So let's say I want to start a new trade, for example using this ATM, and now I click on long, and now what I see is the position corresponding to this new ATM. The problem is when the trade is finished, I still looking at the global position. So now I see that there is a position. I need to check which are the current active ATMs. So I need to select that active ATM, the one with the ray. So let's remove this method, because I don't like it. Let's close everything, close this chart, and let's review how to create a trailing stop and an auto break even. Let's go back to the example, edit. On the second position, on the stop strategy, instead of known, we can click on custom. We can have a method already saved. All this config can be saved as a template. And that template is one of those listed here. But if we select on custom, on the second position, then I can set the auto break even and the trailing stop.
Vamos a ver el auto break even.
For the auto break even, I have a trigger and an offset. So let's say I want to move the stop when I am 5 ticks into the profit. So when the market is 5 ticks into the profit, then I move the stop to this number of ticks from the entry. A negative offset is a worst price than the entry, one tick worst. If I set a zero, then the stop is moved over the entry. If I set a plus one, then the offset is the stop is placed one tick better than the price, than the entry price. If I click on long, now I have the auto break even set to 5. This is the target 1, target 2. Let's move the market to the upside with the simulated data feed. And when I am 5 ticks into the profit, the stop should be placed here, one tick worse than the entry. The other stop is not moved because on the position number 1 there's no stop management. And that's all that it moves. It only moves once because the auto break even only moves one time when the profit trigger is reached. For the first position, I can also add an auto break even or a trailing stop. Now let's review the trailing stop. So let's say that instead of 20, let's move the target far from the entry, and now edit the stop management, and now let's replace the auto break even to 0, move over the entry, and now I add a trailing stop. We have another trigger when to start doing the trailing. When I am 10 ticks into the profit, this is when I have the target 1. I want to move the stop at this distance is different than the auto break even because this is not related to the entry. This is how many ticks I move the stop from the best price that the market did. For example, if I am usually we need to use a trailing size near the stop that we are using. Let's say I use 8 ticks. Click on OK, everywhere. Let's move the market to the downside and go short. Here is the target at 50. Now we are 5 ticks into the profit, move the stop to break even, over the entry. And this is the stop of the first position. When I get this target, this stop is gone. And when I am 10 ticks into the profit, giving fill to this target, the stop is moved 8 ticks from the best price. And it keeps moving. Always 8 ticks from the best price. We can also modify this while it is moving. We don't need to create a new ATM. We can right click the order, and to change something we need to turn off the auto trail. Now we don't have more auto trail, but now we can configure on the properties. And let's say that I want to follow the price 10 ticks behind. Now the price is moving 10 ticks from the best price made by the market. There's another, that's a very interesting tool that we can use to measure the risk reward. We can measure between 2 points of price and get the results in price, ticks. So now we can see that we have 10 ticks. So here we can see there are 10 ticks from the best price to the order until the market goes in the other way and fill the stop. That's the idea of using a trailing stop. We can have several positions. For example, let's remove this and leave the market flat, close position, and let's edit the ATM. Let's say that we want to have 4 positions. So we add here, we select the trade size. Here we need 4 because there are 4 contracts in total, all with the same stop. Use 20, 30, and 40 as the targets. And now let's edit the trailing stops. Let's make them slightly different, one from the other. Remove the break-even. And when we are 10 ticks into the profit, let's move the stop 5 ticks. On the second position, third position, or second trailing stop. Also, when we are 10 ticks into the profit, let's move the stop instead of 5, 7. 2 ticks of difference between one stop and the other. And for the final, the third trailing stop, when we are 10 ticks into the profit, and let's move the stop
6.
Here we have 5, 7, so now let's make this 9. So all the stops are 2 ticks one each other. And now if we go long, we have all the targets. All the stops are together. They are not going to move in the auto break even. The auto break even is not configured. And the trailing stop for the last 3 positions start at 10 ticks when we are reaching the target number 1. So now when we reach target 1, when I get this target, now we get the 3 stops moving, but at a different size from the best price. 5, 7, and 9 ticks from the best price made by the market. If the market makes a small pullback, it may take part or all of the position. But then if it continues to the upside, we keep moving the remaining trailing stops.
sigue. Bueno, algo que se puede
Something that is also useful when we have an ITM like this working, we have two positions, two targets, two stops. So all the position is protected. What happens if I select the current active ATM, the one with the ray? So I want to add or remove position to the current ATM. Let's say we have a small pullback and I want to increase the position again. So we click here to the position that I want to add, one contract for example. And here we can place a buy limit. So if the market makes a pullback to the limit entry order, now all the position goes to 3 and the stops and targets are not moved. Everything is updated to have 3 positions, 3 stops and 3 targets. The stop is using now one of the currently used trailing stops. The first one, the one that is 7 ticks from the best price. Now if I want to remove one position, I can place a sell limit here. And now it got a fill, decreases the number of trades, and also the target and stops are updated to the new trade size. So while we have a ray here, while the currently ATM is selected, we can add or remove positions. Hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question or comment, please post below. Thank you. Bye bye.